Today I'm going to show you how to create a realistic wood burn effect. Hello my friends, and let's get started. So this here is our end result. I will delete the layers and you can see we have just a wood plane. I will link the texture in the video description as well as the font. So the first thing we want to do is click on the text tool over here, and you can click and drag to drag it to the right size. I will write the word wood, and as you can see I used a rather artful font with some grunge destruction already in the font, so this will help us make it feel more natural and real. But you can use whatever font or even icon that you want to use. And the next thing we're going to do is I'm going to duplicate this text so I have basically a safe copy of it, and I will work with that copy. The next thing we're going to do is we have to set the text color to black, so that's important for us. And I'm going to hide the other layer and also lock it so we don't have any chance to click on it by chance. So the next thing you want to do is hold your control button and click on your text layer so it creates this selection. And then we are going to go up here where it says select, grow and shrink, and grow the selection by quite a bit. Not too much, but like this. So you have a good distance to the original font, so you have a larger area. Let's click apply. Let's click on down here where it says add pixel layer to create a new pixel layer. And I will take the brush tool with the color black in it and just fill it. And so we can see we have a nice big black color area where the text used to be. I will now drag this pixel layer down over our background. It's important that it sits right above our background with the wood for our next effect. So go down here where it says filters, click on distort, and then on displace. And displace is going to load the information from our wood layer as a displacement map. So you click down here where it says load map from layers beneath. And when you do that, you can see already it's adapting to the structure below. We will make it even a bit more intense, like this. Click apply. There we go. And now we will make this a little bit softer. Click up here on filters, on blur, Gaussian blur, and just use a little bit. The intensity of the pixel setting here depends on the resolution of your picture, so I can't give you a fixed value. Really depends on how large your file is that you're working with. Okay, now that we've done this, we can set our layer to soft light down here. Let's hide our text layer. And you can see already we have a very nice effect. This is going to be our unsharp edges of the burn where it goes into the material of the wood, basically. And the next thing we want to do is to use our font as the burn mark where the iron stamped into the wood. And I want to show you something here. If you use just the font like I do right now and you go to another blend mode, for example overlay, you can see that here you have some problems, because with some font types like this one, especially handwritten fonts, where one font or how can I say one letter is flowing into the next letter and they're kind of overlaying, you have this kind of problem where you see that there you see the start or the end of the one letter overlaying the other letter. So this is not good. To just work around this is just to right click, set it back to normal, and then right click on it and rasterize it so you have a pixel layer. And this is now just a uniform pixel plane. And now if you would set it to overlay, you can see there is no more problem. So this is how you can get rid of this. And this is also why I created a copy of our text layer, so we can still edit it and have the original font in the file if you want to use it later on. We are not going to use overlay for this. We are going to use soft light as well. And you can see it already looks pretty good. If you want to influence how strong the burn is onto your picture, you can just go here to blend ranges, and there you have different settings like the underlying composition ranges. that gives you a chance to show or to set up where this is influencing the picture. Is it influencing the lighter parts or the darker parts of the picture? So this gives you a chance to make it even more detailed and intricate and maybe a little bit softer like this. Let's make it like this, okay? And two more things that we want to do are selected, this pixel layer selected, we will click on effects and click on inner shadow to create a little bit of a shadow. Let's have an offset here, there we go. And you can see this will give us the effect of a little bit of, how can I say, depth into the wood. So the iron was pressed into the wood, so this wood is sitting a little bit lower than the rest of the wood, so it creates a little bit of a shadow and it makes it look more realistic. And another thing that I like to do now is to create another pixel layer on top of this, and we will take the brush with a large setting. You can see a really large size, the hardness to 0, opacity 100%, and now you can just, I forgot something, sorry. We have to click on the control button again and click on our pixel layer of the burnt text, not the underlying one. And we will use this as a mask for our pixel layer. So let's click back to our pixel layer. And now you can see when we go close to it, it is just influencing our text and not the wood. So we will just put on a little bit of dark black color on some parts, so to make the burn a little bit uneven. There we go. And now we can go Control D to deselect it. And this looks pretty good. And what you can do if you want to influence it even more is, of course, you can use your eraser tool and just remove some of the dark parts that you have added to make it even more uneven. So this is a nice way to give it a little bit more of a realistic burn look. Because if I hide this one, you can see it's a little bit too uniform. It wouldn't realistically look like this. And with this added effect of adding some darker parts to it, it looks a lot more realistic and a lot more nice. Okay, this was the tutorial for today. Thank you for watching. I'm going to create a new tutorial every 3 days. So if you like my tutorials, consider subscribing to my channel. If you want to support me even more, head over to Patreon, where you can download the original Affinity file with all the layers as a supporter. And you can get feedback on your pictures and even live chat with me about your works and the questions you have. Thank you very much and see you in the next video. Bye.